right. How about a live look from space? From Earth to space, a live look from the International Space Station. I got to say, it looks fake. Some of these images, it's so cool we're able to see this.
It's so beautiful to see a shot from up there. Just over a little over an hour ago, we brought it to you live right here on Fox 31 Morning News. NASA launching its largest interplanetary spacecraft, the Europa Clipper.
Okay, so this is the first ever detailed survey of Europa, which, by the way, is an icy moon of Jupiter that is one of the most promising places in our solar system, apparently, for us to potentially live. So new at 11, we're joined by Alexandra Curtin from the University of Colorado's Boulder's Laboratory for Atmospheric and Space Science. So thanks so much for joining us here this morning. Obviously a big, big day. Can you tell us a little bit about this mission in particular?
Yeah, I mean, this has been a very exciting morning. So liftoff occurred and we just detached from all of the rocket stages and sent Clipper off into space on its journey. We're very excited. There's 9 instruments going, and I worked on the surface dust analyzer, or SUDA. That's the instrument that was built here at LASP, and we're very proud of it. It's hopefully going to tell us all sorts of amazing things about the dust in the atmosphere and the space around Europa and on the trip to Europa and some of the other Galilean moons around Jupiter. So it's a big day. It's been a long time coming, and we don't get to go out this far in space very often. So, you know, this is very exciting. So you're showing on next to me. This is the icy crust of Europa. Europa has this fascinating looking surface with all these big scars and cracks on it. It's an icy moon. Underneath, we think there's a liquid ocean, and we have all these cracks where things have escaped into space, and we hope by flying by Europa with all of our different instruments and with SUDA operating that we can sort of characterize the nature of the chemicals, the salts, and things coming out of these plumes on the surface of the moon. So
that's amazing.
It's a cool day for us.
Yeah, and of course, we're a long way off. It's going to be a long trip for everybody to get there, as we know, for those instruments. We also have, and I love this, some photos of the instrument that you guys sent us, and Ralphie, the logo from CU, is right on there. I think that's so cool.
Prominently featured.
Yes, prominently featured, which we love to see. So let's talk a little bit about the instrument that you guys specifically sent up. You say it's the dust analyzer. It's going to try to help, you know, find out what's on the moon there, what's on Europa. Yep. But how long have you guys been working on this project? And now do you just kick your feet up until 2031 and kind of hope it gets there safely? Or what are we doing?
So I was not involved in the original proposal stage of this instrument, but it's been, I would say, I think almost 10 years, I think 2016 maybe. I was not involved until the build stage right before the pandemic hit. We had some staffing changes and I ended up getting to work on this instrument, and it was really an amazing team. We took it through until we delivered the instrument to JPL in the fall of 2022. And it's been there getting built into the Clipper since then. So it's been quite the team to work on it. That little logo that you showed on it, either on the back of that or inside our other electronics box, we have a lot of names engraved for everybody that has gotten to work on this instrument. So what you're seeing there is really only half of the instrument. That's the sensor head. It has a little door on it that will open up, and hopefully the dust that's around Europa and on other places on our trip will come in. And it's what's called a time of flight mass spectrometer. So it will actually tell us the chemical makeup of what's in the atmosphere around Europa, or the space around Europa. So that's a little bit about our instrument. And again, yeah, the team that worked on it was an amazing team. I did a lot of the calibration and testing work in the lab, but I was just one of many. And I think we did a really good job building an instrument that has to survive a very harsh environment around Jupiter.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, long trip to go. That's for sure. Plenty of time to...
I'm going to keep my fingers crossed until 2031 and my toes
exactly.
as well.
Yeah.
I was going to say
plenty of... One point... Yeah. Oh, go ahead.
No, finish what you were saying.
It's a 1.8 billion mile flight. We're going to loop around Mars and then we're going to come back and loop around Earth again, and then we'll make it all the way to Jupiter.
Oh my
so,
gosh.
That's why amazing. It takes so long.
Yes.
Goodness gracious. I wonder where everyone's going to be come 2031. I know, right? That'll be interesting
hard to
see.
Hard to think that far out. Well, awesome job. We're so proud of you guys representing our state, the University of Colorado, and we're going to have to check back in with you guys throughout the journey, make sure everything is going okay on that trip. So well done, and thank you so much for joining us this morning. We appreciate it.
Hopefully you're doing something to celebrate.
Yes, and pass along our congratulations to the entire team as well.